If we choose a number A, which is a positive rational number, and a natural number, say small n, then nth root of A is called a surd of nth order, provided nth root of A is not equals to any rational number. Let us take an example as root 7, root 5, fifth root of 2. Here root 7 is a surd of order 2. Root 5 is a surd of order 2. And fifth root of 2 is a surd of order 5. Is it clear? There are 5 kinds of surd. The first one is pure surd. A surd consisting of a single irrational number is called a pure surd. For example, we can take again root 7, root 5, fifth root of 2. These are all pure surd, because a pure surd consists of a single irrational number. Is it clear? The next is a mixed surd. If A is a rational number and root B is a surd, then A plus minus root B is called a mixed surd. A and B are both rational numbers, but root B is a surd. Then A plus minus root B is called a mixed surd. For an example, we can choose 2 plus minus root 3, 3 plus minus root 5, etc. Is it clear? The third group is compound surd. A surd which is the sum or difference of two or more surds is called a compound surd. For an example, we can choose root 2 plus minus root 3 or root 3 plus minus 5, etc. Okay? Compound surd is a surd which is the sum or difference of two or more surds is called a compound surd. Clear? The fourth group is similar surd. If the surds are different multiples of same surd, then they are called similar surds. Ratio of the similar surds is always a rational number. For an example, we can take root 2, 3 times root 2, 5 times root 2, these are all similar surds. Now, if you find the ratio between the similar surds, you will get always a rational number. Is it clear? Because if we divide 5 root 2 by 3 root 2, we are going to get 5 by 3, which is very much a rational number. Okay? The next group is conjugate surd. If both sum and product of two surds is a rational number, then two surds are called conjugate surds. If we choose two surds and if we add up, as well as if we multiply, we are going to get a rational number, then these two surds are called conjugate surds. For an example, we can take A plus under root B and A minus under root B are conjugate surds. Why? Because A and B here are the rational numbers. Now, if we add, we are going to get 2A. 2A means, again, it's a rational number. Moreover, if we go for multiplication, we are going to get A square minus B. Since A and B are two rational numbers, therefore, A square minus B is also a rational number. Therefore, this kind of surds, when you add as well as when you multiply, we are going to get a rational number. We call those pair as conjugate surd. Is it clear to all of you?
In this problem, they have given us x equals to 4 minus under root 15. So from here we can write 1 by x is nothing but 1 by 4 minus root 15, and if we rationalize it, that is, if we multiply numerator and denominator by its conjugate, so we are going to get in the numerator as 4 plus under root 15 divided by, in the denominator we are getting 16 minus 15, that gives you 1. So your 1 by x is coming to 4 plus under root 15. Am I correct? Therefore, your x plus 1 by x, that gives you what? 4 minus under root 15 plus 4 plus under root 15, that gives you 8. Is it clear? Therefore, it is required to find out the value of 1x cubed plus 1 by x cubed. A cubed plus b cubed, the formula we know, it's a plus b whole cubed minus 3ab into a plus b. Now let me just put the value of x plus 1 by x in this case, which is nothing but 8. So we are getting 8 cubed minus 3 into 8. That gives you 512 minus 24, which gives you 488. Is it clear? So that is the value of x cubed plus 1 by x cubed in this case. Is it clear? In this problem, they have given us a plus b root 2 equals to 3 plus 2 root 2 divided by 3 minus root 2. Now what I'm doing is I'm rationalizing the denominator. So I'm multiplying by its conjugate 3 plus root 2, both numerator and denominator. So we are going to get and in the denominator we are getting 9 minus 2. So in the numerator if I simply multiply, we are going to get 2 plus 3 root 2 plus 4 divided by 7. So we are getting what? 13 by 7 plus 9 by 7 root 2. Is it clear? Now if we compare, we are going to get A as 13 by 7 and B as 9 by 7. Is it clear? Now, it is required to find out A plus B in this case, which is nothing but 13 by 7 plus 9 by 7, which gives you 22 by 7. Is it clear to all of you? Have you understood this problem?